Hey everyone! In this video, we're trying to create an RFID card using another RFID card for the same building. You can see our facility is 22, and the card we want to clone is 48786. For an H10301 card, we'd use 16BE92. Now that we know the hex data, let's create the card on the right. We'll go to Add Manually, H10301, and then we'll type in the hex code. 16BE and then 92. We'll go ahead and save that code and then we'll emulate it on our flipper. This video discusses how to make the hex data for H10301, EM4100, AWID, and Indala26, which are all low frequency RFID cards. Let's get started. If you are on a physical penetration testing job, be sure you get written authorization in your rules of engagement and scope documents. Also, check your local laws. You can see that different cards have different amounts of printed data. The top card has both the facility and the card number. The middle one has the card number, no facility code, and the lower one has nothing. Cards are usually issued sequentially. So even with the blank card, if you can read it, you can create another credential that may have elevated access. The card sends the hex value to the reader, and the reader transforms it to a value the door controller understands. The flipper assumes the facility is an 8-bit code and that 16 bits are for the card number. It's possible your card uses a different format, such as 12-bit facility and 12-bit card number. With this spreadsheet, we can type in the facility and card number, as you saw earlier, and generate the H10301 data, the EM4100 data, and the AWID data. Again, facility is usually the same for everyone in the building, and the card numbers are usually ordered sequentially. Our facility is 101, which is 65 hex, and our card number is 29649, which is 73D1 hex. Our Wiegand is 26 bits, which is 1A, so that's 24 bits for the facility and card number and 2 bits for parity. We calculate even parity by counting all the ones in the facility bits and then the first 4 bits of our card number. There are 7 ones, so we set our parity to make it even. Our odd parity is based on the remaining bits on the card number. There's 6 ones, so we'll set the parity bit to make it 7. Now let's look at AWID. We have 1 for even parity, and then we have our facility, and then we have our card number. And then we have our odd parity, and then 2 zeros. So that's 1A for Wiegand 26-bit, and then it's B2, B9, E8, C0. Next, I wanted to talk about Indala26, which scrambles the bits. You can see only the card number is printed on the card. It's 4594, and the facility code is shown on the flipper as 75. We'll go ahead and enter 75 for our facility code, and then 4594 for our card number. At the bottom of the spreadsheet, we show the unscrambled binary in hex data. As I type the binary values for the facility and the card number, you can see them appear below. You'll notice our even and odd parity bits also toggle as we're adding ones. Now we'll do the same thing with the card number and type in those bits to fill them in. And now you'll notice the hex values are also starting to fill in. And you'll notice the hex matches what's on the flipper. Now you can emulate badges for H10301, EM4100, AWID, and Indala26. Please join my Discord server for flipper-related giveaways and discussions. Also, please take a moment to like and subscribe. In a future video, we can look at the code so you can understand how other low-frequency protocols work.